Johnny Carson. This is Ed McMahon along with Doc Severinsen and the NBC Orchestra inviting you to join Johnny and his guests, Robert Blake, Lola Falana, James Hampton, and Frank Rains. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's Johnny.
Tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tomorrow's the big one, right?
Yep.
Incidentally, I have a late bulletin in the newsroom. Michigan and USC decided to play water polo. Wet film at 11. New Year's Eve. You believe this?
Yep.
Incidentally, this is your last chance to laugh during 1976. You're going to wait till 77, huh? I can tell, there. You want a wild and an uninhibited show tonight, right? But we are not going to start. All right. We are not going to start our new year by playing doctor in the audience. That is.
No.
Tell them to stop that right now. How you feeling?
Great. Just great.
We're going to have a big New Year's Eve celebration here exactly at the stroke of midnight tonight.
Exactly.
We're going to have balloons and we have noisemakers. You'll be the noisemaker and. Incidentally, you probably heard this all over on television and the news. If you are out driving tonight and you have too much to drink, for God's sakes, do not drive. People think when you have, you know, you're in perfect control, but you're not. It's not a lecture. Incidentally, you know what they do in Southern California? There's a series of announcements to discourage people from driving while they're drinking by the Forest Lawn people, the Forest Lawn Mortuary. I know, it sounds weird, but what they advise you to do, in fact, they invite you to stop by certain Forest Lawn Mortuaries for a free cup of coffee. They will give you enough black coffee until you are sober enough to drive home. I think that's a good idea.
That's great.
Now, Forest Lawn claims that they do it as a public service. But I stopped in there once last year, and it's the first time I've ever been measured for a cup of you, Ben. I understand earlier today a guy drove into Forest Lawn and asked for a free cup of coffee, and a voice from underground said, "Make that two." And a female voice from underground says, "You never asked for a second cup of my coffee." That happened today. Ed celebrate, are you going to do the same thing as you did last year? Ed has a unique way of celebrating New Year's. This is really a stroke of genius. Last year he drove up to a Burbank motel, had a case of vodka, a case of Galliano, a bottle of orange juice, threw his dress over a wearing blender and checked in as Mr. and Mrs. Harvey Wallbanger.
And got away with it.
And got away with it, yes, and had a wonderful time. Of course, when we are back in New York, I think everybody looks forward to Times Square, New Year's Eve, right? Where they dropped the, what's the name of the building they dropped in? The Time?
No, it's the Allied Chemical Building.
The Allied Chemical Building. This huge ball falls for, what, 30 seconds?
Yeah.
We see, back in Nebraska, we didn't have that.
What did you
well,
have?
Well, what we did at New Year's. My Uncle Harry came out and threw a capon off the top of a silo. And when it hit the ground, it was New Year's, and we went back to bed, and nothing exciting. Incidentally, the NBC commissary has asked me to ask you, has invited everyone over for hors d'oeuvres on them and free drinks. Unfortunately, they will not be open for another 20 minutes because the champagne is still in the rinse cycle. You know what's ending tonight after 2.5 years in 1976? After 2.5 years on television, the bicentennial minutes.
Oh.
That's right. For 2.5 years, those bicentennial minutes have been on. But if you're a television fan, don't worry. I understand next year, knowing television, they're going to go into reruns. They're not going to miss anything. And President Ford is going to narrate tonight the final. That's true. I understand right at midnight?
Just before.
just before midnight, the final bicentennial minute, and the president's been rehearsing it all week. No, he's hoping if it goes well, he'll get a series out of it. Well, what else is happening? There was an interesting statistic in the news today about smoking. Did you happen to see it? Despite all of the campaigns by the government, anti-smoking campaigns, and the Surgeon General, you know, you now have to put on cigarettes. Cigarettes are what? Hazardous
maybe
to your health?
Yes.
What does it actually say?
No, maybe. What is it?
It doesn't say maybe anymore. Are a danger to your health?
As determined, cigarette smoking is dangerous to your health.
Is dangerous to your health?
Also going to affect your eyesight.
Also affect your eyesight, where you cannot read. Well, with all of that from the government, Americans last year smoked 620 billion cigarettes, which is 2% more than they did in 1975. It only goes to prove we don't believe anything the government tells us, right? I mean, let's face it, cigarettes are bad for you, right? I only smoke one or two cigarettes a year after sex.
Oh.
What?
I just wondering how many packs are you down to?
Tapering off soon. Do you know, this is going to be a fun night. Fun night. We have a special treat for you, too. Did you tell them?
I got to tell
them. Well,
no.
We'll wait and tell them about that. Do you know what's becoming the biggest tourist attraction in the United States? What would you think? Not Disneyland. No, Plains, Georgia. Jimmy Carter's hometown is becoming the biggest tourist attraction in the United States. They expect over 1 million visitors down there this year, and Plains, Georgia is only 642 people, and they're getting ready for this unexpected windfall. And here's some of the things they're doing to attract the tourists down there. They're opening a chock full of grits. They're featuring a Maw and Paw Kettle Film Festival on the side of a barn. I mean, a lot of things like that. And they're putting leisure suits on the scarecrows. But they're going to have bigger things, and we'll keep you informed as we go along. Tonight, we have, to celebrate New Year's Eve with all of you, Mr. Robert Blake, Miss Lola Falana, James Hampton, and Frank Rain. So thanks for coming. We'll be right back. We'll be right back.
Love, soft as an easy chair.
Barbara Streisand, Chris Christopherson,
fresh as the morning air, warm love that is shared by two.
Two lovers who had everything.
If you ever doubt, I'll kill you.
But sometimes, everything isn't enough.
I am never going to die.
Barbara Streisand, Chris Christopherson. A Star is Born. Now, at a theater near you. Rated R.
Thank you, good doctor.
1976 is, as you know, rapidly growing to a close. So to usher in the new year, we thought it would be fitting to meet the symbol of 1977, the New Year's baby. Please give a warm welcome to the next year's 1977 New Year baby. So you're the New Year's baby.
And they told me you weren't too bright. That's
right. I see you're wearing the traditional diaper.
Yes, it's just like the Bermuda Triangle. But nothing ever disappears in it.
Greetings to you, 1977.
You can call me 19.
You ushered in...
Informal.
Yes, the New Year. Did you bid goodbye to Father Time?
Was that the old geezer in the white beard?
Yes, with the long white sheet.
That was Father Time.
Yes.
I thought that was a retired Ku Klux Klanman from Camp Pendleton. I can tell.
You are...
She's ready.
It's okay now. You're the New Year's baby, but at the end of the year, you know, you will be an old man. You have rather a short lifespan.
You're not kidding. I go from prickly heat to prune juice in 1 year. My entire life in 1 year. You know, my peak sex period is from 3:30 to 4. It's in the afternoon on May 17th.
Oh.
I hope my diaper rice clears up by then.
Yes, I do.
Otherwise,
too.
I go right by it and miss it.
I want to ask you what 1977 holds in store for us.
Well, don't ask me. Why don't we ask our ex-wives' lawyers?
Seriously, will it be a good year?
It'll be good if you're a peanut farmer from Georgia. If you're a skier that falls down a lot, it'll be the pits. What?
Do you have any specific predictions for 1977?
That's why I'm here.
Oh.
I predict... Grown man!
Graduate of University of Nebraska.
I predict... In 1977,
yes.
Carl Malden will have his hat removed surgically. I also predicted... Yes, I will. The prevailing easterly winds will blow the...
I know it's hard for you to speak.
Yes, it is.
This is your first night of life.
First day. Yeah. You don't really speak well for a couple weeks. That the winds will blow the oil slick from the Argo Merchant back to the Middle East, where the Arabs will raise the price and resell it to us. That's what I predict. I also predict not all of these predictions will be funny. I predict during his underwater explorations,
yes?
Captain Jacques Cousteau will make an unusual discovery, which will either turn out to be a shark wearing a tuxedo or the body of Norman Maine.
You were right.
From A Star Is Born. And it will be discovered,
yes?
That for the past year, Jimmy Hoffa has merely been sitting on a bench waiting to catch an L.A. rapid transit bus. He is not gone.
Now, have you any predictions in the field of show business?
Yes, NBC will throw a giant party to celebrate the last Mac Davis special. Which may be a long time in coming. Charlie's Angels be arrested on the set of their show for loitering in front of the cameras. We show no mercy.
In outer space?
Yes.
Will there be any advances made?
Certainly. Mary Hartman.
Yes.
Will be the first person to dock with a space station.
Mary Hartman. Mary Hartman.
That's right.
What about the unemployment situation?
Well, if the rest of the year goes like this bit, there'll be a lot of work for guest hosts. That's one of the things that will happen.
What about the world of sports?
How about that? Ooh. The Los Angeles Rams will travel to the Super Bowl.
That's fantastic.
They'll be seated in the upper deck where they can get a nice view.
What do you see on the horizon for the political arena?
I think that spiritualists will make contact with the departed and Will Rogers will say that he can't stand Robert Dole. See, Will Rogers always said, I never met a man I didn't like.
And Robert Dole was there.
That's right.
Yeah. No need to mess
That's
me up
right.
with it.
You're part of this. Because of Jimmy Carter, large yeah. teeth will become popular and Mr. Ed will make a comeback.
It sounds like it might be a very interesting year. What else can happen in 1977?
Unfortunately, viewers will witness a tragedy on coast-to-coast television.
They will.
The captain of Captain and Tennille
yes.
will get his brains bashed in by a runaway pong ball.
Do you think the Howard Hughes Will problem will be settled?
Yes, they'll find the real Will and learn that Howard Hughes left his entire fortune to the Society for the Prevention of Any More Osman Brothers.
Are there any other surprises?
One more.
Yes. That should be enough.
Patty Hearst will not have to go to jail. A judge will sentence her to stay home for 15 years in front of her television set and watch every game show hosted by Gene Rayburn. Well. Jeez. I've got to go now. Should have gone some time ago.
Wait a minute. What is your hurry?
It's time for my 2 o'clock breastfeeding.
Well, wait just a second. What is your big rush?
I've got to find a donor.
After we pause for this brief intermission, we'll be right back with more of the show, so stay right there.
When I get a bad cold, my mother spoils me. Look at all these medicines. All I really need is a fixed NyQuil, the nighttime cold medicine. NyQuil relieves the sneezing, stuffy head, cold capsules do, coughs, scratchy throat, like cough syrup, aches like a pain reliever. NyQuil alone does all that, so I could get the rest I need.
Got everything you need, son?
Oh, yeah, Bob. She's terrific.
NyQuil alone does it all.
Listen to the Akins, winners in a Publisher's Clearinghouse giveaway.
We just started saving for a down payment. Then our entry won a big cash prize.
Now we're fixing up a home big enough for all of us.
You may be lucky, too. A new Clearinghouse giveaway is in the mail now. Top prize, two homes are $125,000, plus motorhomes, vacations, cars, cash, thousands of other rewards. Just to call attention to our fine magazine values. Check your mail for the Publisher's Clearinghouse giveaway. You may be a winner, too.
Back.
Yes. Baby 1977. There are, by my clock, 11 minutes to the new year.
Well, you have a good clock.
Yes.
Now, around the country, we will be celebrating. And
I was just going to say, I told you last evening, it's hard to believe 19 New Year's Eves we spent together.
That's right. That's a long time.
That's a long time. Happy New Year.
Well, Happy New Year. And we'll say it again in about 10 minutes. We have Lola Falana with us tonight. Actor James Hampton, Frank Rains here. Frank's an interesting man. He's going to make some predictions for you tonight. What's more interesting is the way he makes those predictions. That's all I will tell you.
Right.
You'll find it fascinating, though. And this gentleman, whom you all know, probably television's biggest star right now.
Right. Because of this show.
Well, I don't know. Because of his show.
No, because of this show.
Well, he doesn't work on this show.
He will admit that this show made him as popular as he
is. You think so?
Yes.
Oh. Well, I'd like to hear that. Certainly made us as popular.
That's right. This is it for us.
Brett is the name of the show. Robert Blake. You stole something else out of wardrobe, huh?
As a matter of fact, yes. It's here one of my Kiki outfits.
That's right.
You know Kiki?
Sure.
Kiki's cool. He's on the show on which I'm a star.
Kiki's just a little hint of mint in Kiki.
I'm a star of that show.
I like your old lady better. I like the old lady in the show.
You like my old lady?
No, the old lady you play.
The old lady I play?
Yes.
Oh, that old lady.
I like her.
I'll come out here sometime as that old lady, and I'll kiss you in the ear.
Don't you like to play old ladies or something about you?
I love it. Sure. Yeah. Not. You wear all that funny sponge and go around kicking people.
Hiding the character. How you doing tonight? You seem a little more
cool
tonight.
Oh, I'm wonderful, John. I'm wonderful.
No therapy?
No, I'm terrific. I'm the star of a series. It's wonderful. I'm successful. Very nice. Comfortable. I do these tacky talk shows occasionally.
Now they're tacky.
I just said that you got your popularity from this show. Is that correct? Yes or no?
Oh, Wimpy, my boy.
Now tell the truth.
This being the eve of the new year, I must confess that I was a failure until I came here and bared my soul to you, John.
Well.
And America took me to their heart and gave me a series. Now I got $1 jillion and you can all go to hell.
How's it going? You hanging in there all right?
Oh, I'm fine. You know, I have no troubles.
That's good.
We play that game here on the show where I'm neurotic and I have all these problems and that sort of thing, but you got to have something to talk about, you know.
I always thought you were putting me on a little bit with that. I think you're really
completely
well-adjusted, happy, no emotional stress.
I don't have no troubles.
No neuroses or anything like that.
I wish this thing was a dress.
Out. We all have our little problems, but that's nothing. I'm talking about unusual things.
No. Most of the time, I'm cool. I have no, I don't dig the holidays all that much, but that ain't no grave situation.
How'd you do at Christmas?
I made,
I made about
$4,000, as a matter of fact.
What do you mean you made?
I have, now see, you've been in this business for a while.
Yeah.
Not as long as I have.
That's right. You started at the earlier age than I did.
The old days.
But I'm older than you are.
With me and Spanky.
Right. That's right.
But I'm older. But I'm older than you are.
No. When I was born, I was about 36.
I didn't know. Right, taking that into account.
You have a minor edge on me.
Yeah.
But all things considered, I feel kind of paternal toward you most of the time.
Oh.
I come out here and like to bail you out and keep you rolling. My heart breaks back there when you're standing out there croaking, but you sneak by.
Boy, you must have a lot of money put away. You must have it nailed. Coming on like this. Don, what do you mean you've made $4,000 for Christmas now?
Everybody in show business is, because it's so frenetic, I guess, they're always into things. You know, they're into booze, and 90% of them, one time or another, are into horses. Now, I maintain that nobody can make money betting horses, betting football games, betting anything that's out there. The only time I ever bet heavy is on myself.
Yeah.
I play poker, or I'll shoot pool with the best of them. I'll shoot you one-handed, and I'll use a broomstick.
Well, you're using your skill there.
Myself.
That's
and
right.
I know what condition I'm in.
Right.
But nobody can go up and say to the horse, how do you feel today? You see.
What bothers me.
So, now on the show is Tom Yule. And I love you, Tom. But when the horses are concerned, you are a dummy. I want to tell you that. And there's Kowalski and all these guys, and they bet and they work the horses.
With
now,
all the charts
I have sat
the
there
sheets.
And heard them talk about things like this. They get a chemical analysis of the dirt of all of the tracks in California before they run, because they have to know what's going to happen to the dirt when the rain falls on it.
That's right.
If there's too much sand in it, it behaves one way and that way. And I say it's... I mean, it's all...
Baloney.
It's baloney. So...
Boy, you got a lot of money. I'm only up to damn, and I got a lot of money. You must be loaded.
Two more Berettas, and I'll
have... Don't do it. We got to cut away in just a couple of seconds, because we want to come back.
20 seconds?
Yeah. You see, well, we're going to come back, though, because when we come back, it's going to be just a few seconds away from the new year, and we want to celebrate.
And America wants to celebrate the new year.
That's right.
With me, you, and Wimpy.
And everybody is at home. Doing whatever they're doing at home.
Right.
So we are going to cut away right now, and we will be back about 10 seconds before midnight, wherever you are, right after this. Stay where you are.
Why do I shop at Sears? It's easy for me. I can pick up tennis balls, children's clothing, torque wrenches, and a dish all in the same shop. Use my charge card, and it's just simple and easy.
We're at a Sears store to find out why Sears is where America shops.
They have what I need in the size and the color that I want. I can bring it back. They'll exchange it, replace it, refund it, whatever I need to make me happy as a shopper.
Sears, where America shops.
You don't give up, do you?
Sometimes.
Not you.
What are you protecting these people for? You know how many they've killed?
Sacrifices have to be made, mister.
Do them in.
Oh, you can count on that.
Eastwood is back. The dirtiest Harry of them all. The Enforcer. Rated R. Now playing everywhere.
In a major movie about the most daring rescue of all time, coming Sunday, January 9th.
Well, it is 10 seconds before the new year, and exactly 12 o'clock, Doc is going to do Auld Lang Syne as only the Tonight Show band can do it. It's like 3, 2, 1, happy 1977. Jimmy. Hey.
This is terrific.
This is nice. This looks like an Elks convention I was at once in Omaha. Look, you gotta have a few noisemakers and confetti and stuff like this on New Year's Eve. Otherwise, you know, it's not
wonderful.
Really New Year's.
It's wonderful.
You'll hear it many times in the next day, but from all of us, we hope that 1977 brings all of you your best wishes, whatever you hope for one another in the world, and that probably is to try to get along with each other around the world as best we can.
Amen.
Make the effort.
Amen.
And now, and to follow up musically, since it is New Year's Eve, once again, here's Guy. The boys will be here again next year. Well, we thought we'd confuse a lot of people tuning in. They won't know what's going on. We're talking with Robert Blake in 1977.
Unbelievable.
You know, when I was a kid growing up, did you ever think ahead and you said, the 1800s, the 1900s, that you'd live to the 20th if you get to the 21st, the year 2000? Now, what are people going to call that? Are they going to say 2000, 2001, or are they going to say 20 and 1? I had a discussion with my wife last night on that. If the year's 2025, are they going to say 2025, or would you say 2025?
2025.
I opted for the 2000, the year 2000.
2025, yeah.
Yeah, who cares? Yeah. If we're not around, they can call it a pickle as far as I'm concerned. But if I'm there, I want a voice in that. I think 2000, because they did the Kubrick picture, was 2001. Does it make any sense at all? Would you like to volunteer any information on this at all?
I'm drunk.
Your eyes dance a little bit, don't you?
I'm whappered.
You have a little glass of wine?
No, I had some brandy, a little brandy-rooney. It don't take much when you're doing 14 hours a day.
No, that's right.
The gorilla labor there.
Yeah, well,
because you're right on the edge at all times.
Especially when you get tired and you don't eat. And I'll bet you haven't eaten much today, have you?
It don't make no difference. If when you're that exhausted, you pump in a little bit, and the olive oil comes right out of my skin.
They say, when you're tired and you drink, it only takes... just like that.
That's all. Could I go back out in the audience?
Now, your wife will kill you. You were out there smooching.
I'm cool, man.
Cool.
I'm cool. I got a lot of money. If my wife don't leave me, I'm home free.
She's not going to leave you, is she? Sandra wouldn't leave you.
I don't know. It could happen.
What happens when you fight? You walk, you leave the house? You cool it and say, okay, I'm going for a walk.
No, the blood flows. It's terrible.
Yelling, screaming?
Yeah, after all this time, it's still terrible, man. And I think it's all over, and she thinks it's all over, and it's the end of the world, and we call the lawyers and all that stuff, and then somehow or other, love will out.
Because the lawyer tells you what it'll cost. Right? And then all of a sudden, oh, I love you more than I thought. No, I'm just teasing.
You're a bad man, John. A cynic at heart.
No, I'm not.
I would like to wish you for the new year... that the hair in your nose turns to Brillo. That's what you...
And may the wind at your back never be yours.
Not guilty.
I thought the show had changed hands. It's not a big enough name for Schlosser. He's sending gunmen now. Contract is out.
I don't believe it. I feel I got the super inferiority palpals.
Really?
A major mal seizure of it. Because I'm sitting here.
Right.
On New Year's Eve. Not Burt Reynolds and not Donald Duck and not, you know, whatever, but the old grunger, myself.
I would have you here even if you didn't have Beretta.
I'm sorry, it's a weird thing, you know, it's just, it's like sitting back there in the big dressing room instead of waiting over in the corner in the green room, you know, with your brown bag with your lunch in it.
Right.
And where do I go from here? But I will adjust.
Can't you accept that?
No, I adjust. You can see how I've adjusted. It's wonderful. Everything, that I have no problem. It's cool. Can you say...
Did you ever get rid of that car?
The Gray Ghost.
Did you ever get rid of that car you had?
The Gray Ghost.
And get in anything?
No. No, the Gray Ghost is being driven now by fats. I got this wino. Well, he's not a wino anymore. You know, if you watch the show that I'm on, which I can't mention because it's another network, but it's something like Barfetta, but it ain't exactly. One of the cops on it, the black guy with the glasses, and he talk like that. He say, man, they're killing me, they're killing me. His name is Fats, Chino Williams, and he is a drunk, a wino. I mean, a full-fledged wino, and he has a long record in the pen and all like that. I hired him as my right arm to keep the other winos away from me. You see how cool I am?
Right.
See, because downtown at Fifth and Los Angeles, there's nothing down there but juicers. And you don't want to hire some big guy to lean on him and punch him out and all like that. So I hired Fats. Now, Fats turned out to be cool. And I said, Fats, if you stop drinking, you could be an extra on the show. So he turned out that he could be an actor. So now he's one of the detectives on the show.
I think that's great.
And Fats needed some wheels to get to work on account of he lives down there. So I loaned him the Gray Ghost.
The Gray Ghost.
But the Gray Ghost will never leave my person. When I'm old and gray... The ghost and I will go off in the sunset together.
You got to hang on to something of some sentimental value.
I have a lot of trouble with that.
It's the material thing. You know.
I don't let things go too easy. I got to hang on to, like your little box. See when they broke your box, how tense you got?
Rickles broke that.
That's
and,
right.
We glued it back
repaired
together.
It. You see that? Now, that's very strange, gang. If you want to think that you're different from the folks sitting up here, you ain't. Because here's John, success... Jillions, all like that. There's a dumb little box. Dumb to you and me, but they broke his box. Now, when somebody broke some...
You're not going to break it again, though.
No. They took John's box, and he glued it back together again.
We had it fixed. I didn't go out and buy a marble or a gold or anything like that. This is just a little nice, but that has sentimental value.
I understand that. I got a lot of junk around like that.
That's what it is. That's what it is. It's junk, but it's sentimental junk. Don't you care? Keep old clothes?
Well, I keep...
Sure you do. I've seen what you wear.
I keep practically everything.
Yeah.
I don't want to... See, we're not going to discuss my problems tonight.
Oh, okay.
So I will not talk about it as a problem. I was going to say, I have a problem. I can't let anything go, but that's not true. I just keep a lot of that stuff around because I like it.
Right.
That's right. But if you can't sleep with it and you can't eat it, to hell with it. That's the New Year's resolution, Gary.
I think that's pretty good. Yes. Gonna do a commercial? All right. We have Lola Falana with us tonight. We have James Hampton. And Frank Raines is gonna predict for us and do some unusual things.
Predict?
You're gonna predict what's gonna happen.
Very good.
Predict right here on our stage. We're coming right back.
It is now the other side of midnight, which is also the name of a new major motion picture being made from the sensational bestseller. We're filming it in Paris, Greece, Washington, Hollywood, where its fascinating story of the rich, the beautiful, the ruthless unfolds. This summer, the 20th Century Fox and Frank Yablon's presentation of The Other Side of Midnight will come to a theater near you. If the book took your breath away, when you see the movie...
Listen to the Wunderlichs, winners in a Publisher's Clearinghouse giveaway.
I didn't have a retirement plan,
But with this check for $100,000, I do now.
It's wonderful. Now we can send our boys to college.
You may be lucky, too. A new clearinghouse giveaway is in the mail now. Top prize, two homes or $125,000, plus motorhomes, vacations, cars, cash, thousands of other rewards. Just to call attention to our fine magazine values. Check your mail for the publisher's clearinghouse giveaway. You may be a winner, too.
Down again. It'll be a good year.
All right.
Okay. Now, my next guest, I think she was on the last time you were here, strangely enough.
Lola?
Lola, I think, was on the show one night with you, was she not?
Whatever Lola wants.
Anyway, Lola's been nominated for a Tony Award for Dr. Jazz on Broadway. She won a Clio. Do you know what that is?
Gee. Don't ask me that tonight, John.
No, I'm not sure. We're going to send you home in a large doggy bag tonight. No, Cleo helped in the writing and performance of a commercial she did for a perfume company, for a Tigris commercial. And you can watch her win the AGB Award for Song and Dance Star of the Year, which is on the AGB Award show on January the 16th. Would you welcome Miss Lola Falana?
Pray, 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 pray. You got to pray, pray.
Happy New Year, Ed.
Now, that's the way to get the New Year cooking.
Oh.
Well, that's like down-home church stuff, you know?
Yes, it is.
I almost took up a collection. I mean, that is. That's got a lot of earth, country, rock to it. Church stuff, right?
I did it because I feel so good.
Yeah, that's the
I got the power in me.
Yeah. Hey, well, give me the power.
Yes.
Amen.
You got the power.
We have... I'm getting carried away.
Come on.
We have a word from Liquid Drano to start your new year. The Liquid Drain opener that delivers more power to the clog.
Oh.
That's where you need it.
Hold still, Joey. We've got to get home. I got a sink chun clog.
Me too.
With all the hair you wash, Barney, I'll bet you've got drain problems that just won't quit.
Right. But for hair, I got a solution that just won't quit.
Liquid Drano?
Watch it work on this clog. Drano can handle even this much hair. That's more than you can ever get in your drain.
Yippee!
All finished.
So's Drano.
Take it from Barney. Liquid Drano just won't quit on hair.
The Excedrin headache. It comes in all sizes.
It's like in a beautiful day. And then a nagging little headache starts in right here.
It's the ordinary, crummy, medium headache that makes me grouch at my wife and mess up at the office.
It's the kind of headache that gets me between the eyes.
When fast, effective relief is really important, get the extra strength of Excedrin working for you. Get to know Excedrin Relief. Because any size headache is an Excedrin headache.
It's beautiful when the pain stops.
Be the first show that gets busted in 1977.
Woo!
You gotta move on New Year's Eve, right?
Oh,
you do all the time anyway.
I'm just getting
And Happy
started.
New Year, by the way.
Happy New Year to
You'll
you.
You'll hear that for the next day or two from everybody, but...
Happy New Year, Doc, to the band, everybody.
All right!
Alexander, girls, singers
open them
in the
cages.
Back.
You got any special plans coming up this year?
I'm not gonna make any resolutions. I'm gonna get a suggestion box.
Just have people give you suggestions?
I lie anyway. I'm not even going to get involved.
You're not?
Because I lie. And because...
Well, he's making him anyway.
That's too much pressure.
Yeah.
Last year was tough on me trying to keep up with myself.
You made too many resolutions and you feel guilty that you don't...
Suggestion box. See, that's not so finalized.
Yeah, that's true.
Because you can get very tedious. This year, I'm going to do simple things that I've been torturing myself with, like...
Simple things?
Like try to get to the bathroom before I'm in crises.
The little things in life that are important. That's important.
It is. It's very important.
Yeah.
I can't tell you about my day at the doctor yesterday. It was amusing.
Well, then don't tell me if you can't tell me, because if it's personal. If it's personal, up with...
No, it's not personal. I mean, this is America. You know, these are human beings. I mean, what could a doctor... I mean, I'm not bionic. What could a doctor tell me that they probably wouldn't have the same problem themselves? See, I thought I had severe kidney attack or something because of the pressure on my lower...
Well, that could hurt.
...abdomen. It was kind of puffy, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, I knew I wasn't pregnant, you know, because... Mm-hmm. Well, you kind of know that, you know, when you're pregnant. So... And then I figured... And then I figured just because it was Christmas, it didn't mean there had to be another conception.
Right, so...
So...
In other words, he found the problem and treated it and everything's fine.
Yeah, he said... He wrote a prescription for me. He told me the pressure was there because I had to go over the pot.
It's going to be a long year. Well, it's New Year's Eve, folks. I mean, silly things happen on New Year's Eve, but you're better now.
I never felt so free before. You know, I feel really great. It's nice.
We did a show together, and I mentioned that you are the singing and dancing star of the year from AGBA.
And you know why, John?
Why?
There were some wonderful things that happened in my life, but you were one of the wonderful things that happened in my life. When I was nobody.
Yes?
You reached out your hand to me, John.
Yes.
Yeah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yeah, brother.
Amen. You called me unto your bosom, John.
Yeah, amen. Right.
Called me unto your bosom.
Bosom. Amen.
And
amen.
You said to me,
Holy. Amen.
Little girl, let me save you. And so you opened the door. This man here had me on his show when you didn't know my name. Couldn't even say it. You were calling me Lapapalooza.
You were on the show a number of years ago, sure.
Oh, they called me Lola Fandango. Well,
now everybody knows it's Lola Falana.
Yes.
And I'm happy for you and have your success and everything. And yes. I hope it just keeps going wherever you would like it to go.
I hope so, too, because there's no easy way down. I can't take it.
No.
I can't take it.
I mean, you want to stay right up there.
I've grown accustomed to myself.
Okay, well, we're certainly half fine. Have you got a light? Well, we're going to take stock and see who's here. We're going to come right back. I know there's three. I know there are three people to my right, and we're going to be right back.
New Year's Day on NBC begins at 7 Pacific time with the Junior Orange Bowl Parade. Then join Michael Landon and Kelly Lang for the Tournament of Roses Parade. You'll see fabulous floats, marching bands, and more in a salute to the good life. Later, it's the Rose Bowl as the Wolverines of Michigan take on the Trojans of USC at 1:30 Pacific time, followed by the Orange Bowl as Colorado takes on the Buckeyes of Ohio State. Catch all the pageantry in action New Year's Day on NBC.
What happened to that train, girl?
Me and my friend, Victoria.
Go on.
In 1931, the nation held its breath when 9 young blacks were accused of attacking 2 white girls. One of the most explosive dramas of our time. Arthur Hill stars in the true story of Judge Horton and the Scottsboro Boys, a film intended for mature audiences. Parental discretion is advised. See Judge Horton and the Scottsboro Boys, Monday at 9, 8 Central and Mountain on NBC.
And followed by Quincy on NBC double feature Sunday mystery movie starting at 8, 7 Central.
Look, did you guys get things grooving again with the guys?
Oh, yes, huh? Yes.
You feel in the mood?
Yes. What's
okay.
The first line of my song?
First line.
This is a New Year's song. Because it's New Year. Don't look so sad, y'all. I know it's over, but this life goes on. The world's gonna keep on turning, so let's be glad for the time that we spend together, and don't you look back to the bridges burning. Just lay your head, lay it on my shoulder, and lay your warm and tender body next to mine.
For the good times.
For the good times.
And we'll take a break, and James Hampton will join us for some more good times.
Good times.
Remember the disc jockeys? Segway.
Tuesday on Bob Bob Black Sheep, Happy Boyington gets upstaged by a movie star turned flyer.
You have been withdrawn from the Kamabachi action.
Because of a movie actor?
Home front Morales scraping bottom. It needs a shot in the arm.
From a drugstore cowboy like Towers.
Is it true that you did your own stunt plan in Do or Die?
Sure did. I do the flying, doubles do the crashing.
Then on Police Woman, Angie Dickinson takes her biggest gamble. Bob Bob Black Sheep and Police Woman. Tuesday, starting at 8, 7 Central and Mountain Time on NBC.
This is Edwin Newman. Why is America as violent as it is? Americans hate violence as much as we say we do. Why do we flock to see it in sports, movies, television, and the press? You'll see some shattering answers in the special 3.5-hour NBC reports, Violence in America, Wednesday at 8, 7 Central and Mountain. This program deals realistically with such subjects as murder, rape, assault, and child abuse. Parental discretion is advised.
Thank you.
blocks off the Adolf Hitler Hotel on the Parkling Drive coming to you from the Red and Blue Room. Oh.
One of those radio remotes I used to do?
Yes.
My hotel, Chestermore, in downtown Detroit, a few blocks off the interchange. Just drive in, it's the toe-tap music of Barney Fiedler and his Cowman things. Don't know what I'm doing. We have a fine young actor to... What is that for? What? Yes, fine young actor, not coming in from there. James Hampton has been with us many times before. He's... I think you're low a quart. He's just finished co-starring in a movie made for television called Howard, the Amazing Mr. Hughes, which obviously has to do with Howard Hughes.
How intuitive you are.
Would you welcome James Hampton?
Why not? What up?
Happy New Year, Jane.
Happy New Year to you, John.
Yeah. What are you looking forward to this year?
I'm looking forward to being sober. No. I'm looking for... I'll tell you, I got something for you. I'll show you.
Really?
I got this in the mail today. Look at that.
Well, it's...
Now, Bob Hope gets those all the time, but that's...
The inaugural committee...
That's it.
...requests the honor of your presence and participation... well, it's Southern printing here. ...and participation in the inauguration of Jimmy Carter... It doesn't say James Carter.
Jimmy Carter, isn't that nice?
...as President of the United States of America, and Walter Mondale as Vice President of the United States on Thursday, the 20th of January, so-and-so-and-so-and-so, in the city of Washington. How did you come by this? Well, obviously, they mailed it to you.
They mailed it. Did you get yours?
No, I did not get one.
You won't be going, then?
No, I'm going out to Durwood Kirby's house.
Because I was hoping...
We're staining his den.
I was hoping we could drive down together and split...
No, I did not get one. How did you...
How did I get it?
Well, they're not sent to everyone, obviously.
I didn't get one.
How about that? Well, I don't know. I tell you what, last May, I wrote him a letter.
Well, said send me an invitation, huh?
No, this is the truth. I wrote him a letter and said, I read your book, and I hope you get elected, and you're... And that was it. And they never asked me to send them any money.
Or anything, but you got it.
Now, that just gets you into the parade and the, you know, I'm not saying that I'm going to all the parties and all that, because they had a... This was inside.
Oh, what is this? Ignore previous invitation. No.
See,
we sincerely hope you'll be able to come to so-and-so. Here's some of that. We deeply regret due to the limitation of space.
Yeah.
This invitation cannot be honored at the ceremony.
That's right.
You're out of that.
That's right. Well,
the inaugural parade.
Well, I can, see...
We would like more than anything to be able to invite everybody.
But that's going
to
look good in the den, isn't it?
Well, we know that you understand. Well, this doesn't, where does this get you?
It doesn't really get you anything.
You didn't get any special tickets for admission to the invitational ball or the inaugural ball.
Actually, you get more with a golf invitation these days, you know.
But you can go watch the parade.
That's right. But I think this is kind of Southern. They said, you're going to see a new openness and a new spirit. See that in Washington?
Yeah.
We hope that after you visit, you will take that spirit back to your home. I mean, isn't that folksy?
You good old boy.
I know it.
Yeah. Come back now.
Go get him, Jimmy.
Yeah. Where are you from originally? You're from down...
Texas.
You're Texas way. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. What did you do New Year's Eve, special on Texas?
I tell you what, these people will know they're just clapping.
Oh, I know what those are.
Black-eyed peas.
Black-eyed peas.
Do you have them on New Year's Day?
I haven't for a couple of years.
Well, I brought
Why, is that a...
those are for you?
Well, bless you.
You got to cook them, of course. I mean, if you eat them like that...
Why are they special for New Year's Day?
Well, it's good luck. We eat them on... We eat them on New Year's Day, don't we?
Black-eyed peas? Collard greens? You make up some collard greens?
Collard greens, if you like.
What street value of that, Johnny?
What? What's the street value of this? Look, after they've been cut 20 ways, I mean, you know...
Yeah.
Whew. We got to start taking a check on this audience.
I tell you what you do with
them. All right, now take them and put them in hot water.
That's right. Soak them all night long. You know what to do with these.
So cold, you start with cold water, do you not?
Well, you can. And if you're going to soak them all night long, you just put them in water.
Soak them all night long, then what?
And then you cook them with a ham bone.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Or are like, any kind of pork fat or
fat back, is that what they call it? Fat back, like that?
Salt pork, bacon. Right.
They really are great.
Oh, they're dynamite. But talk about the wind at your back, which you're you've got to... you've got to,
I love it. To the pot.
Well...
You don't want to drink any prune juice.
It's all right, now. Look, you pay for your thrills. You know, if you enjoy those type of things, you pay.
That's right.
You used to
we
be...
Have
It's all right. We've never talked about this before, and I don't know why.
I don't either.
Why? Well, I know I do, but because you know what I'm going to say.
No, I don't.
You were on the television series. You've done a lot of different shows on the F Troop.
Yeah.
That was on. That had, what, 3 or 4 year run?
No.
2 years.
2 years, right, yeah. 2 years. And then it went into, they all recognized me. That's wonderful. Mm-hmm.
That's how big the show when it was on.
It was
with Larry Storch.
Larry Storch and Ken Berry and
Morris Tucker.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Bob Steele was in it. Did you know that?
Yes, the cowboy actor.
Yes, right.
And you?
And they're dying to know. So probably want to know some stories from those good old Halcyon
days. I don't think so.
No,
but if you have any, why don't you tell one?
I'll tell you. Well, this
get
is
get out of the way and
yeah. Boy, oh boy.
It's hard to follow the black eyed peas, isn't it?
Apparently.
Yeah.
A lot of Texans out there. thanks, Bob.
This one you'll enjoy. This story you'll really enjoy because Jim tells this really well.
Which side have you been working?
Tell him the story. Will you hear this?
Okay.
Jim tells this one so
good. Larry's.
You're going to
tell the Larry Storch story?
Tell him
famous.
Whatever you want, you want.
Yeah.
He does it so well.
One day, Larry, I know, I'm just really. The new year. Larry Storch became the character that he was playing. He became a little paranoid and strange. And he's married, I don't know if you know Larry too well, but he's married to Norma, who is kind of tough lady, mm-hmm. You know, a little Broderick Crawford, you know.
Well, and, not very kind to say about
it. She looks like Joan Crawford, though.
You know, I see.
She's nice looking, but she's tough because you have to be with Larry. And one day, Larry came up to Tuck and said, I'm in a lot of trouble. He said, Norma bought me a new pair of glasses, paid $80 for them. She said, don't come home without these glasses. And he says, I've lost them. I've looked everywhere. Tuck said, don't panic. Did you look in the pocket of your chair on the set? He said, oh, I can't look there. He said, why not? I said, because if they're not there, they're really lost. That kind of stuff happens all the time.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Just funny things like that on the set, one after another, huh?
Yeah.
You think you're going to be doing a new... Are you looking for a new series?
Or not
anymore. Do people know who you are yet when you come out? We've talked about that.
Yeah, I know.
The name, when they see you, they say, oh, that's the guy that did. I saw him on the commercial the other night. He was in the F Troop. He did the thing on Humps. He did the show with the camel. And his name is Hemp Jim.
Yeah, I know.
Well, yes, I know what it is. And your brother obviously knows, too. Well, I'm talking about the regular people.
No, people think that they know me from other pursuits, other lines of work, other... You know, they think they worked with me or they were in the army with me or something like that. And if I say I'm an actor, they go, no, I know you. I was in Vancouver recently and did a show there. And we... All right, I just sit here and name towns and do better than I did with the others.
That's right. So you're up in Vancouver.
There is a section in Vancouver that's the Bowery. It's the pits, you know, but they have a Chinese restaurant that's open late, and sometimes I just got to have some Chinese food. So we were down there, and a lady of the evening came up to the table. Not your $100 lady of the evening.
This is
your cut rate, bargain basement lady of the evening.
Wouldn't know.
A lot of lumps. Well, this one probably, you know what that kind of means. She just... She was in the pits. She's... you've been there. So she said... She walked up to me and she said, are you a lawyer? And I said, no. She said, are you a prosecutor? I said, no. She said, are you a cop? I said, no, I'm an actor. She said, get out of here. And she ate my egg roll. That's the Vancouver story, but the...
You should have never brought on the peas. You start going downhill as soon as you did the bag of peas, but...
Yeah, I'm going to do it. I did a pilot. I'm going to keep going, John. I'm keep going till the guy comes out and predicts.
Well, he's coming out soon.
I know. I predict he'll be right out.
You got it. You hit it. Look, sometimes you have to be cruel when you go into the John. I mean, that's it.
Hey, they can't.
Look, if a guest bombs, we move him. Out comes the funny guy. We'll be right back after this.
Move up.
That's right. Move him out. Move him out.
Now, for the first time on television,
Scramble.
The real story of the most daring rescue mission of our time.
Operation Thunderbolt is a go.
The action and excitement in the major motion picture about the commando strike that thrilled the world. Raid on Entebbe. Starring Peter Finch, Yaphet Kotto, and Charles Bronson as General Dan Shomron. First time on television, the real story of the raid on Entebbe. Super Bowl Sunday, January 9th at 8, 7 Central Time on NBC.
A big double feature NBC Sunday mystery movie. First,
you threatened him, Murchison, and he gets killed.
Max not dead, but he's not safe. Someone tried to kill him, and he'll try again. Rock Hudson is McMillan with guest star Karen Valentine. Sunday at 8, 7 Central Time. Then, a fortune in diamonds and attempted murder spelled danger for the chief medical examiner. Jack Klugman is Quincy. McMillan, then Quincy. 3 hours of action, Sunday, starting at 8, 7 Central Time on NBC.
Entertaining gentleman with us tonight by the name of Frank Rains, who, when he was on the show some years ago, made some very accurate predictions of what he foresees for the future. So we asked him to join us tonight, and he said yes. He had nothing planned. Would you welcome Frank Rains? Welcome back. Happy 1977. We got all the New Year's out of the way. Okay. How many years have you been making predictions now?
About 28 years now, Johnny.
Yeah. How do you base your predictions? I mean,
What's
your accuracy percentage?
I would say somewhere between 75 and 90%.
75 to 90% accuracy? That's...
Well, there's a lot of unknown factors that are involved.
Has it made you rich or anything? Can you predict the stock market and stuff like that?
I don't deal in that. There's a lot of unknowns there, too, see?
Yeah. Okay, in other words, if I ask you, how about if you see something frightening in the future, would you predict that? Or does that turn people off?
Well, rather than take a chance that I could be wrong and it would upset someone, I really probably would not predict anything. It would have a personal tragedy to it.
All right, now, let's start. May I ask you a question about the future?
Be happy if you do.
All right. What do you see for the country coming up?
Beg your pardon, go ahead.
What do you see for our country coming up in a space picture? Do you think that the world will find peace at this time? Can you tell me if the man sitting over here, the guy's... Now,
let me...
Hold it. Now, wait a second. Now, wait a minute. Hold it. Frank, stop it.
Come on.
I must explain what happened. He was on the show about 8 years ago.
It's like the gym. Give him some black-eyed peas.
Now, let me explain, Frank. Let me really explain. We had Frank on the show about 8 years ago. You're from Chattanooga, Tennessee, right?
Originally, I'm from Alabama, but I'm in Birmingham, Alabama now.
And he came on the show, and somebody brought him on, and I didn't know anything about it. And he started this business of repeating things practically on top of you and drove everybody crazy. And you've been doing this at... you go down to lecture circuits and you go to a place and they bring you in as a ringer, right?
I have done that, you're right.
What is the trick on this?
No trick, it's a gifted ability. Anything anyone says in any language, well, I can say the same thing at the same time, and makes no difference who I'm talking to, and I enjoy your laugh, because even though I would laugh like other people, I would tie in right with James' laughter, and, you know, and...
Now, ask him...
Say something funny, John.
I want to show you what it feels like.
That's embarrassing. And Lola be all right to talk with you, too. I think your singing is great.
Thank you.
And I'll get home every Wednesday night to watch Beretta.
Too bad you don't mess with me, man. I can't care.
You know what it's like? One second. Oh, shut up, Frank. One second. Frank, stop it. I want to explain what it sounds like. You hear it. It's like talking to yourself through earphones that are about a second. Would you shut up, Frank?
Big star, I'll have to do that.
Un momento, por favor. Un momento, por favor. ¿Dónde está el hombre? She says, predict something. No, you don't understand, Lola. It's a joke. He's not really a predictor.
He ain't a predictor?
You're not a predictor.
You're going to do this all night, that's it?
Well, I'm going to be awake. You're going to move. I can't take it all night.
You better
get
something fast. Yeah.
Why wouldn't
you
get out of here early?
At least I would have been so lonely.
Get out of here. One second. I want to ask a legitimate question now.
Go right ahead.
This is so fascinating because when you're listening to other people, it sounds completely different. And then when you start to talk yourself, would you shut up? And you even get the inflection.
Right.
At the same time I'm saying it. Monsieur et madame, nous sommes à bord d'avion en route pour Paris.
Let's punch
you out.
Let's beat him up. You're making it right for you.
I'm coming over
there. We're going to let you have it. Come on. Let's get it.
Come on, Mark Fetta. Let's get it.
You get it, brother.
Let's get it.
Beat him up.
Come here, Doc.
Come on.
If you think this is a put-on.
Put on. One of the guys who speaks Italian.
Hey, bring the trumpet.
Come on now, just say something.
Who is he?
Well, when you want me to meet him over there, you're going to bring him over here?
Yeah, he can't do it long distance.
I can't speak it.
Frank is going over there.
I can't speak it.
Where's this Italian speak? Let me speak with Doc just a minute here. Let me say, I've never met Doc on camera before. Doc, I appreciate this band. I know everybody else do. You do a great job.
Thank you very much.
You know when it would be great? You know when it would be great to be able to do this? When you're having a fight with your wife, and she starts going on you, and you go right. Well, Frank, this is a picture I didn't realize. We worked together 18 years ago.
Down
in Chattanooga.
I know how to stop him.
How?
When you start talking about him, he quits.
No, no, talking about Johnny. Look at the picture.
No,
here. Look at the picture.
We were talking about him, and he started answering you.
Look at the picture.
We were doing. We were doing a television show. Monitor. We were doing a benefit or something, I think, down in Tennessee. And I hadn't realized until somebody told me tonight. That was 18 years ago. You were a little slender, and I was a little darker haired. A little darker haired than I am
now. I'll tell you something you forgot, too. Another star was with you that night. He was working in Chattanooga with a TV station. His name from Alabama was Gomer Pyle.
Jim Neighbors. Jim Neighbors, I went down there, drove me around.
That's right.
The city. I went down there to do a thing, and he was driving, working for a local station. He drove the car.
Right.
Yeah. Well, this is fascinating. How long have you been able to do this?
28 years.
You don't have to study it at all? You just learn it?
No, just a gift.
Just a gift.
It's a gift, right.
That's a gift. Okay, we're going to take a station break out, and we'll be right back. Don't go away. Shut up, Frank. It was nice to have all of you here tonight. I thank you. Happy New Year to you, too. Right down to the bottom of the paper bag, huh? I thank you for giving. Tomorrow is the game, right?
Yes.
Tomorrow is the game. But I thank you for giving up part of your New Year's to come here with us tonight and for everybody watching around the nation tonight.
We're honored.
And Frank, it's delightful seeing you again.
My pleasure. I enjoyed it immensely, especially with such great stars.
Thank you. And Jim, Lola, Robert.
Thank you, Johnny.
David Brenner will be here on Monday night with Sonny Bono, Marilyn McCoo and Billy Davis, Kelly Monteith, Susan Anton, and New York's Jimmy Breslin. Have a most happy, peaceful, and prosperous New Year.